If you want to load your website fast, you need to know how to properly resize, optimize, and compress your images. So if you want to learn how to do it, stay with me. What's up, Source Hackers? Sinead here from CoinPassiveIncome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much faster than they'll do it on their own. So if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So first, before we actually start with this video, I want to show you one of the main problems that I can see on like really big number of websites, and that is that images are first off not properly resized, and then they are not optimized and compressed at all. So if we take a look at this image, it looks really normal, nothing's bad here, but if we try to refresh this page, you will now see that it is going to take quite a lot in order to load entire image. And like I said, this is something that is happening really, really often. And if I would refresh, okay, so let's say network, and then I will refresh. So I'll stop this one and refresh again. Let's now check the timing here. Check how long does it take to load entire image. So as you can see, it really takes a lot of the time. And one of the first things that I usually suggest to do is to properly go and resize your image, because let's say I will grab this small tool, click here, you can see now that this image is actually on the page 500 pixels, but if we actually open this image in the new tab, you will be able that this image is like really, really big. And as you can see, it's 5,759 pixels by 3,898, which is like huge image, you can see. So now most people, when we say that they need to resize their image, they usually think that they need some expensive software in order to do it. And it is a case, because if you want to go with the Photoshop or any other tool, it is pretty much expensive. But there are big number of online image tools that we can use to properly resize images. And one of those tools is resizeimage.net. It is something that I use pretty often because it does a great job. And as you can see, I am using the Linux, and on the Linux, I don't have an ability to use tools like a Photoshop. Of course, there are some other tools like GIMP, but it's not something that I prefer. This is just much easier. So the process with this tool is that we need first to upload our image. Once it's uploaded, they will show it here. So let's just wait a few seconds. Okay, it's here. Now they give you an options to crop your image if you want, but in our case, we don't want to. We want to use original just so we can see the difference in the size and the speed load. Then after that, you are able to rotate if we want to. And then at step four, this is what is important for us, which is to resize our image. Now we can resize it by percentage, so we can change it, and as you can see what will happen. But as you can see, for our website, we actually need 500 pixels. So I will say inside this tool that I want 500 pixels. And then I want to keep aspect ratio so that it's properly resized. And then they have calculated and said that it needs to be 308, which is fine for me. Okay, for the options down below, we are able to choose like what we want, but I usually say no fill. We don't want image distortion. And then down below, we are able to make some additional options. I usually just say I want PNG, and that's it. I will leave it to default compression, and I will hit resize image. Now within a few seconds, you will be able to see that they have resized, and they say that our old image is 11 megabytes and the new image is 313 kilobytes. So I will download image. Now, I believe that you expect that quality of this image will be really, really bad, but when I show you comparison, I think you will be surprised, but let's see. So let's say resize it and I will save. Now here I have created just very basic HTML document where I load the image. So first one is original, then I want to use the resize it. Okay, resize it. And of course I upload everything to my website, because if I test this on the local host, we wouldn't be able to properly see the difference on when the page loads. So let's see. Now I will hit refresh again. So you can see now this resized image is already loaded, while the original image, it really takes a lot of the time and it keeps loading. So let's do it once again. So we can also check this part in the network. So I'll hit refresh. Okay, boom. So as you can see, our first image that is resized is loaded 1.57 seconds, while the second one is taking really, really long time. Okay, now one additional method that I usually use in order to optimize images even more is to compress those images. So for that, I'm using one, again, free tool. The name is TinyPNG. Website is tinypng.com. And process is, again, very simple. I will upload resized image. They will immediately compress and I will be able to download. So as you can see, they say that they have made it 75% smaller image. And that way, you can see in the first, we had 350 kilobytes, now it's only 80 kilobytes. Now let's download. And I'm sure that again, you will be like, you are thinking that this is going to lose the quality, etc., etc., but stay with me. So now I will say this one is compressed. Okay, and I'm going to upload those two again. Okay, and let's check our website now. So I'll hit refresh. And now as you can see again, the difference. Third one is loaded like immediately. Then the second one, the one in the middle, and then the first one, which is the original image. And now if we check our network tab, we are able to see like huge difference in the speed load. As you can see, even compressed image load like a second small faster than only resized image. And if you take now a look at those three images, I'm pretty much sure that you are not able, just like me, notice any difference between those three images, except in the huge difference in the page speed load. Now, of course, you can see now that there isn't like a huge difference between the one in the middle and the last one in the terms of the speed. But if you have like 10, 20, 50 different images on your website, that can like make ginormous difference in the speed of your website. So pretty much to sum this video, you have like two steps. Like first one is to resize the image, then after that go and compress that image, and that's it. You need just a few minutes and the speed of your page will dramatically increase and it will be much faster. So guys, I hope that you have enjoyed this video. If you do, please like it and share it to your friends. And like always, if you have any questions or anything, make sure that you post that in the comments below. Take care.